So here again, we have our dynamic trace, now a bit bigger. Remember that the input was a double quote followed by a less than sign. What we get in the end is the output, which is just the less than sign. In the dynamic trace, we can now again follow back the dependencies. For instance, from out, out being read here, where was it last written? That's over here. So this depends on this earlier statement. Here we have out that's being read. Now in the dynamic trace, you can actually follow this whole thing and see where it was last written again, which is up here. And here we have the character C, which stems from the second iteration of the for loop. And this relates to S, which depends on the input. So again, we have a chain of dependencies, out going up here, up here, up here, up here. And you can also see this as a cause-effect chain. S had this value, therefore C became a less than sign, which was added to out, which finally resulted in the input also having a less than sign. Again, we can use these dependencies to build a slice. However, now the slice would be a dynamic slice because it is built on the dynamic trace. Starting with the assert statement, we see that out equals out plus C is being executed and therefore part of our slice. We see that the initialization of out is part of our slice. We see that the for loop is part of our slice. And of course, when we call remove HTML markup, where S is being set, this also becomes part of our dynamic slice. So far, we only looked at dynamic data dependencies, but of course, there's also dynamic control dependencies. Every condition that gets evaluated, that is executed, and controls whether a statement in question is executed or not, builds a dynamic control dependency. Therefore, since we execute out equals out plus C, the controlling conditions are also part of the dynamic slice. From these conditions, we again get more dynamic data dependencies, which we can look up again in our dynamic trace. For instance, here, the tag variable, which is being read over here, was last set up here. Therefore, this condition is data dependent on this initialization. So here's a quiz. Which other statements in the program are also part of the dynamic slice? Is it quote equals false? Is it tag is set to true? Is it tag is set to false? Or is it quote is set to not quote?